Hello and welcome to another episode of the Centuria Show. And today I'm really excited because we will discover the magical city of Hong Kong. And I will be with my good friend Bombi, which has his own YouTube channel where you can discover the coolest places in Jakarta. And he's making pretty dope hyperlapses, so go check out his channel. And we are going to be discovering Hong Kong together because you have been how many times in Hong Kong? Two times, yeah. So
yeah,
he knows it like his second home almost. No, right.
No,
I'm kidding.
So I just been there two times.
Okay, that's already great. So we'll be discovering like the coolest and biggest attractions of Hong Kong and give you a general informative video about Hong Kong. So let's get started. Hong Kong is a metropolitan area and de facto special administrative region of China. Is it like independent country or?
No, it's not independent.
No.
It's like states in the United States. It has but it has its own currency and border control to China. Okay. So people from China can just go to Hong Kong. They need to go stamp their passport.
Yeah. Okay. So it is located on the Eastern Pearl River Delta of the Southern China Sea, which is like a big economic and urban region in southern China, where you also can find other cities which you also have been to.
What I heard is the population of the Mekong, the Delta area, is around 120 million.
Yeah,
that's so huge.
Yeah. Often when I make like top tens and I put like Pearl River Delta in the top because it's obviously the most populated urban region in the world. Often people get really angry because like they don't understand. So, but yeah, it is actually one of the most populated urban region in the world. So you got big cities like Guangzhou, Dongguan, and Shenzhen, which 30 years ago was like small. Maybe not Guangzhou, but most other places was like small fishing villages, I guess. Yeah. And they have just merged together in the last 20 years. So Hong Kong is the oldest city, I guess, in that part. Maybe not oldest, but
I think Guangzhou is oldest.
Yeah, maybe, but it was like really important in the 19th and early 20th century, and still today we can say, but because it was like an English colony until very recently, until
1997.
And so it never really was independent. It is like a state, as you said. So
but it's quite different from a state since it has its own money, currency, border, and law.
Yeah, that's right. Hong Kong has become one of the most significant financial centers and commercial ports. It has always been one of the largest ports in the world, and and has really developed a financial economy. It is the world's 10th largest exporter and 9th largest importer, despite being only populated by 7.5 million inhabitants, which is, as you can see, 103rd in the world. And the GDP per capita is, of course, very high. It is the number 10 in the world with around $60,000. And Hong Kong is the city and country, of course, where there is the highest concentration of super rich people.
Yeah, it's funny. Yeah. When I went to Hong Kong, there's a lot of supercars everywhere.
That must be impressive to see.
To see.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
There are many touristic attractions. It is one of the most visited places. As you can see, the skyline is really... this picture is not the best, but... The skyline is really iconic. Yeah, you can see many skyscrapers everywhere. This is like the Victoria Island, the central part of Hong Kong.
No, that's the Hong Kong
Island. The Hong Kong Island, sorry. Is there something that is called Victoria Island? No, that's just me.
No, that's
just me. Yeah, great. Okay, Hong Kong Island. And so that is where you can see most of the old central area.
Downtown,
Though the tallest skyscraper, this one, which was...
it's in Kowloon.
Okay, great. We can see like this.
Kowloon.
Yeah. It's just north of CBD. Now that we have presented Hong Kong from like the historical and the economic point of view, we can switch on and go to Google Maps and discover really the city.